Him out and say, sons, what must I do to be saved? I want you to keep note of the words of the jailer. He uses two strong words. Number one, must. Number two, save. When the word must is used, it simply means the most important and the only requirement. No plan B, no option B, because he's asking them, sons, what must I? What must I? Is there anything that I must do so that I can go to heaven? Is there anything that I must do so that I can see the kingdom of God? Is there anything that I must do so that I don't go to hell? The word saved, he says, what must I do to be saved? The word saved simply means being delivered from the powers of eternal damnation, never going to hell again. You know, when we are doing our soul winning, sometimes when we ask people what they understand by the word saved, people will give you different definitions. Others will tell you to be saved is to dress well. To be saved is to stop smoking. To be saved is to be a good person. To be saved is to pray every day. But brothers and sisters, even without referring to the scriptures, the word saved comes from the word save. It's an action, and only a powerful personality, a powerful subject, a powerful power can save you where you are helpless. Say, for example, if I was in my house and my house was on fire, at that point in time I cannot deliver myself, I am in risk of dying, what will happen unto me? I'll begin screaming, calling for help, and whoever will come and secure me out of that trouble will be called my savior with regards to that situation. This man is asking Paul and Silas, what must I do to be saved? What is the requirement, the must requirement that I'm supposed to do so that I never go to hell? So if you are hearing me right, this is the point. This is a man who is asking a question to Paul and Silas because he does not want to go to hell because of his sins. Number one, in that question, he realizes that he's in danger of going to hell. You know, when you begin to ask someone, what must I do to be saved? What must I do to go to heaven? It begins from you being informed that, hey, you are in danger. The probability, the chances of you going to hell are high. Any sin that you have ever committed in your life is enough to take you to hell. It's not about a big sin. It's not about a small sin. No. Any sin that you've ever committed in your life and you are still in that condition, you have not come to a point of asking Paul and Silas, what must I do to be saved? You have not come to a point of agreeing to speak to our soul winners, agreeing to speak to Pastor Paul, agreeing to look out for the truth. That sin is just enough.
Odi. How are you?
Fine.
What's your name?
On your daughter, I think.
Neza waongelesha ama nisiwaongelesha? Okay. That's your mom? Okay. I am Pastor Paul Weringa. I come from a church known as Faithful Word Christ Baptist Church. This church here. Do you go to church?
Yes.
Which one?
PAG one.
Oh, PAG. Okay. Are you a Christian?
Yes.
Okay. Now I want to ask you this question. Do you believe that one day you will die?
Yes.
Okay. Now the question is, when you die, where do you think you will go?
I'll go to heaven.
You'll go to heaven. 100% sure?
Yes.
Okay. That is good. So if you think you'll go to heaven, what did you do which makes you think that you'll go to heaven?
I help my friends at school.
You help your friends at school?
Yes.
Okay. Did the Bible tell you that if you help your friends at school, you'll go to heaven?
That's what our teacher told us.
Okay. Is it the Sunday school teacher or the teacher at school?
The teacher at school.
What did your Sunday school teacher tell you?
He told us that one day Jesus would come.
Yes. And then take you to heaven.
Yes.
But he never told you what you are supposed to do to go to heaven.
Yes.
All right. So the reason why I am here is to help you through the Bible to show you what you are supposed to do to go to heaven. Do you want me to show you?
Yes.
Okay. The Bible says in Romans chapter 3, the Bible says in Romans chapter 3, verses 10, as it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. What this means is that we are all sinners. When you sin, it means you have broken the commandments of God. Is that commandment that says, thou shalt not steal. When you steal, you have committed sin, right? Is that commandment that says, you have to obey your father and mother. When you don't obey them, you have broken that commandment. Therefore, it means you've committed sin. Understand?
Yes.
So, have you ever broken any commandment of God?
Yes.
Okay. So that's why the Bible is saying, you are not righteous, I am not righteous, because also for me, I have broken the commandments of God. Therefore, I am a sinner, okay? So now, the question is, if someone is a sinner, when he or she dies, where will he or she go? Stop that. Where will he or she go?
He or she may go to hell, or he may go to heaven.
Okay. So according to you, this person who is a sinner may go to heaven or hell, isn't it? But according to the Bible says a person who is a sinner is supposed to go to hell. Look here. It says, Romans 6:23, for the wages of sin is death. Any sin that you have committed in your life, the payment is death. You see, it's not going to heaven. It is death, right? Now, when it speaks of death here, we are not just talking about dying physically. We are talking about that moment when your spirit, your soul, goes to hell. Let me show you that. The Bible says in Revelation 21:8, the Bible says, but the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. So when your soul goes to hell because of committing these sins, including lying, that is called death. Second death. So what happens? When you die in your body, that is the first death. When your soul goes to hell, it is the second death. Now let's go back to the question that I asked you before. You believe you are a sinner, isn't it?
Yes.
According to the Bible, when you die, where are you supposed to go?
To hell.
To hell. That's bad news, isn't it? Okay. But there's good news. Okay? The good news is that God does not want you to go to hell. He wants you to go to heaven when you die. And because you are already a sinner, there's nothing you can do to go to heaven. It is only upon God Himself to find out a way of helping you to go to heaven. Even if you try to help people at school, even if you try to be a good child to your parents, even if you try to be a good person in this home, God says you are already a sinner. And He says the penalty, the payment that He has to give you is to go to hell. Bad news. So you see, no matter what you try to do, you can never save yourself, isn't it? So God has to save you. Let me show you the good news now. In Romans chapter, we go back to Romans, where we read about going to hell. The Bible says, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. That's good news. The bad news is the payment of your sin is to go to hell. The good news is God has a gift for you. A gift is a free thing, isn't it? If I give you a gift, you don't have to pay me anything. You just have to receive it, and that is done. God is saying, if you don't want to go to hell, if you don't want to be paid the product of your sins, He's saying you have to take a gift from Him. And this gift is called eternal life. And this life is in Jesus Christ. Do you know what Jesus Christ did on the cross?
He died for our sins.
He died for our sins perfectly. That is why the Bible says, verses 8, chapter 5 says, but God commended His love toward us in that while we were yet sinners, Christ died for us. Now, the reason why Jesus Christ died for me and the reason why Jesus Christ died for you is because we are already sinners. And it's because there's nothing we can do to save ourselves. Understand? Jesus never committed any sin. Jesus was a righteous man. But God, His Father, saw that it was good to allow Him to die on the cross so that you never go to hell. Now, if Jesus Christ paid the penalty of sin on your behalf, are you supposed to go to hell? If Jesus has done it on your behalf, you were supposed to go to hell. But Jesus now says, I did it on your behalf. I was crucified and went to hell for 3 days and three nights, and I was doing that because of you. Are you supposed to go to hell again? You are not supposed to go to hell. So the question is, now that Jesus did it for me, what am I supposed to do on my part? Okay? Because look, even if you try to be a good person, you cannot go to heaven. But now that Jesus did it for you, there's hopes that you will go to heaven. But then what are you supposed to do after Jesus Christ has done everything for you so that you go to heaven? This is what you are supposed to do. Acts chapter 16, someone is desperate and someone wants to go to heaven. This person does not want to go to hell and is asking Paul and Silas a very good question that I want you to also see and consider. Acts chapter 16, verses 30, and brought them out and said, sirs, what must I do to be saved? This is a policeman who is asking this question to Paul and Silas who are in jail. So he's asking Paul and Silas, what must I do so that I will never go to hell? What must I do so that I go to heaven? Because if you go to hell, bad news. You'll be in hell forever in the fires. So any wise person would find out before he or she dies what to do to go to heaven so that as you continue living on this planet Earth, you are always safe. Because immediately you breathe your last breath, it's done. So he's asking Paul and Silas, sirs, what must I do to be saved? They answered him this way, verses 31. And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and thy house. So they told this man, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus died for your sins. He did everything for you. What God wants you to do is to believe in Jesus. That one alone. God does not want you to help your friends at school so that you go to heaven. God wants you to look at Jesus and believe in him. Believe that he's the one who died for your sins. He's the one who went in hell for 3 days and three nights because of you. And once you believe that in your heart, with your whole heart, God will never take you to hell. John 3:16, the Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting. That is very clear, that God gave his Son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross because of your sins. That you, if you believe in him, you will not perish. To perish is to go to hell. You understand? But instead of going to hell, you live forever. You get everlasting life. Understand? Says verse 18, he that believeth on him is not condemned. God is saying, this young man, if you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, on matters going to heaven, God will never condemn you to go to hell. God is not a liar. God is not going to look at how good you are. He's not going to look at what did you stop doing. No. God is only looking for one thing. Did you believe in my Son? The Bible says, if you do so, you'll never be condemned. But he says what? But he that believeth not is condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. The reason why people are going to hell, all of us are sinners. We deserve to go to hell. But there are sinners who are going to heaven, and there are sinners who are going to hell. The sinners who are going to hell is because they refused to believe in the name of the only begotten Son of God. Let me show you a good example of people that are going to hell because they thought that doing good things will take them to heaven, and Jesus tells them that is not the case. Matthew 7:21, the Bible says, not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. Jesus is saying, Lord, Lord, will not take you to heaven. But you do the will of his Father, what his Father wants. So you are going to do what his Father wants so that you go to heaven, or you are going to do what you want so that you go to hell. You have a choice. Either you are going to find out what is it that the Father of Jesus wants me to do, or you ignore that and say, I'm going to do what I think is right to go to heaven. Jesus is saying, Lord, Lord, will not take you to heaven. Verses 22 says what? Many will say to me in that day, Lord, Lord, have we not prophesied in thy name? Some people will stand before Jesus and tell him, can't you remember us preaching in your name, Jesus? And in thy name have cast out devils? And others will be telling Jesus, we rebuked demons out of people using your name. And in thy name done many wonderful works. Jesus, we did many good things in your name. We helped our friends at school. We gave people food. I was an obedient boy to my parents. I did all these things in your name. What is the answer of Jesus? And then I will profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, you that work iniquity. Listen, if you are going to be helping your friends at school in the hope of going to heaven, that day Jesus will tell you, I never knew you. Though you thought that that is what you're supposed to do to go to heaven. So helping your friends is not bad, but it can never take you to heaven. Understand? What you are supposed to do is to do the will of the Father of Jesus, to do what the Father of Jesus wants. So what is the will of the Father of Jesus? John 6:40 says what? John 6:40. What is the will of the Father? And this is the will of him that sent me, that everyone which seeth the Son and believeth on him may have everlasting life, and I will raise him up at the last day. The only thing that the Father of Jesus wants you to do, the only thing of the Father who sent Jesus to die on the cross wants you to do, is to believe in Jesus, period. And when you believe in Jesus, you get what is called everlasting life. And when you have everlasting life, it means no matter what, you will never go to hell. Now, let me use this as an example. Let's assume this is everlasting life, because it's a gift, isn't it? So, the Bible said, what are you supposed to do to get everlasting life? What are you supposed to do to get everlasting life? To believe in Jesus. So let's assume, let's do it practically here. So when you believe in Jesus, you get what? Everlasting life, isn't it? Now, if it is everlasting, can it ever end? Is it temporary? It is permanent, isn't it? So Jesus is telling you, when you believe in him, he gives you everlasting life. It is yours forever. Is there anything that is going to happen to you to lose it? There's nothing whatsoever. Okay. What if you have it, it is permanent, it is yours, but tomorrow you find yourself committing sin and you have it? Where will you go? You have it, an assurance that you will go to heaven no matter what. But tomorrow, as a child of God, you commit sin. Where will you go? To hell. Now, why will you go to hell when you have everlasting life? Why will you go to hell? Did Jesus tell you that you have to stop your sins to go to heaven? Did he say that? What did he say? What are you supposed to do to go to heaven? To believe in Jesus Christ. And when you believe in Jesus Christ, you get what? So if you have everlasting life, will you ever go to hell? What if you sin? Where will you go to when you have everlasting life? Just think. You have everlasting life, you are saved, but tomorrow you commit sin. And remember, Jesus did not ask you to stop your sin so that you go to heaven. Jesus only said, believe on me. But now you have everlasting life. And tomorrow you're still a human being, and then you commit sin. Where will you go to? You'll go to heaven because of what? You'll go to heaven because of what?
You have been saved.
Being saved. Okay. When you get saved, it means you have believed on Jesus.
Christ.
And you receive what? Everlasting life. Now, let me again prove to you that you can never go to hell no matter what. Number one, Jesus said this. John 10, 27, the Bible says, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me, and I give unto them eternal life. Jesus says he gives to the sheep eternal
life,
which is everlasting life. Then he says, and they shall never perish. Keep note of the word never perish. They shall never go to hell. Neither shall any man pluck them out of my hand. Jesus is saying, immediately you believe on him, you are in his hands. No one will ever take you out of his hand, and you can never go to hell. You see, what you have to do is to believe Jesus by his word. It is Jesus telling you these words. You have the choice of believing in what he has said or doubting. If you believe, you get everlasting life, and you know that no matter what, if I die even today, or even when I die as an old man, I'll still go to heaven. Not because I became a good person, not because I stopped my sins, but just because I believed on Jesus Christ. You understand? Says this, my Father which gave them me is greater than all, and no man is able to pluck them out of my Father's hand. He says even his Father cannot allow you to go to hell after you believe on Jesus Christ. Now, I know that maybe you have some questions towards me concerning, are we just going now to sin? Let me explain this. Are you the firstborn? Okay.
I'm the second.
You're the secondborn. All right. Let me ask you a very funny question. How many times did your mom give birth to you? One. Okay. So you were once born by your mom, once, isn't it? And forever you will remain to be the child of your mom, isn't it? So keep note of that. Once you are born by your mom, and forever you will remain to be the child of your mom, no matter what, isn't it? Now, if you do anything wrong against your mom, will that stop you from being the child to your mom? No. The same applies to God. The moment you believe on Jesus Christ, that is when you are born in the family of God, and God will begin to look at you as his child. Once you are born in the family of God, forever you remain to be a child of God. Let me show you that. The Bible says in John 1:12, the Bible says, but as many as received him, him as Jesus, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. So the moment you receive Jesus, it means you believe on Jesus. That is when you are given power to become a child of God. Understand? So at what point do you become a child of God? When you believe in Jesus. And when you believe in Jesus, it means you have received Jesus. So that is the moment you are once born in the family of God, and forever you will remain to be a child of God forever, no matter what. That means you have everlasting life. When you did something wrong to your parents, what do they do? If, for example, maybe you have failed to do what they asked you to do, or maybe something has been done in the house and they know that it's you who did it, which is wrong, what do?
They can punish you.
They can punish you. And when they are punishing you, does it mean that they love you or hate you?
It means that they love you.
It means that they love you, isn't it? Do you ever think that in doing so, you can stop to be their child? No. The same applies to God. God is saying, you are saved permanently, you go to heaven when you die, but if after you are saved, you go committing sin against him now being your father, he will also do the same as your parents did unto you. He will chastise you, he will punish you. And when he is punishing you, he shows that he loves you. Understand? Because now you cannot go to hell. So any sin you commit here willfully, you will face the results in your body. God can cause you pain. God can cause you grief. God can make you sick. God can make you, you know, go hungry. God can punish you with any kind of punishment as your father, as your spiritual father now, because of Jesus Christ. It says this. Hebrews, inasema, for whom the Lord loveth, he chasteneth. The word chastises to beat. So the Bible says, if God loves you, he will chastise you and scourge every son whom he receiveth. So the moment you received Jesus, you became the son of God. You remember? Now he says, if he loves you, he will chastise you. And God will only beat you when you are doing something wrong, isn't it? Says, if you endure chastening, God dealeth with you as with sons. For what son is he whom the father chasteneth not? The Bible asema, if God is beating you, you should know that he is beating his son. Then he's asking, which kind of a son is not beaten by his parents? Then he says, but if you be without chastisement, whereof are a partakers, then are you bastards and not sons? The Bible says, if you realize that you are just committing sin the way you like, and God is not punishing you, you are not his child. You are a bastard. A bastard is a fake child. So how do we know that we are children of God? If we want to prove, if we go to sin willfully, and then God will come and punish us very severely. So you know what? I don't want God to be punishing me every day. So you know what I'm going to do? To keep his commandments. Keeping his commandments, not so that I go to heaven, because going to heaven only requires me to do what? To believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Understand? So this is what I have said. For you to go to heaven, you only need to believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. And when you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, you get everlasting life. And after you get everlasting life, no matter what happens, you will go to heaven. If you commit sin while you are still here on planet Earth, big mistakes, big punishments. Small mistakes, small punishments. You understand? Now, I want to ask you one serious question, then we finish. This, for example, is everlasting life, isn't it? Okay. If you commit sin and you have everlasting life, will you go to hell? Where will you go to? Heaven. What if I commit suicide? What if I kill myself? What if I kill myself? Will I go to heaven or hell? Good. You go to heaven. Understand? So if you commit suicide, it is sin. But now that you've killed yourself, you will not be here for God to punish you in the body while you are here. You are already in heaven. God will punish you when you are in heaven. You'll never go to hell if you commit suicide. You go to heaven. But while in heaven, God will punish you. Let me show you that. It says in Matthew 5:19. Matthew 5:19 says, whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments and shall teach men so, he shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. The Bible says, if you break the commandments of God as a child of God and you teach other people to do so, when you reach heaven, you will be called the smaller. You will be the backbencher in heaven. So when you commit suicide, it means you are living a bad example on earth, isn't it? So when you reach heaven, God will put you back. You will be the backbencher in heaven. But he says what? But whosoever shall do and teach them, the same shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven. Understand? So if you keep the commandments as a child of God and teach other people to love God and keep his commandments, when you reach heaven, God will call you great. Okay? Now, you have to believe on Jesus Christ so that you go in heaven. Are you willing to call on Jesus now to save you?
Yes.
Okay. Repeat this prayer after me. Say, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
Please forgive me.
Please forgive me.
Of all my sins.
Of all my sins.
And give me.
And give me.
Eternal life.
Eternal life.
I believe that.
I believe that.
You died.
You died.
And rose again.
And rose again.
Because of my sins.
Because of my sins.
Jesus.
Jesus.
I trust in you.
I trust in you.
Alone.
Alone.
For my salvation.
For my salvation.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For saving me today.
For saving me today.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I am saved.
I am saved.
Amen.
Amen.
What's your name again?
I am Flavian.
Flavian.
Yes.
Congratulations. If we never meet, my name's Pastor Paul. If we never meet, we will meet in heaven. But since there's hope for you to continue living and maybe for me to continue living, one day when God blesses you and encourages you to visit us in our church, this is my number. And if you have friends that can help, you can help to reach the gospel, if they have smartphones, if they scan this code, it will take them to our YouTube channel and they'll hear the gospel that I preached unto you so that they also get saved. If you want to know anything more about our church, they scan here. And if you want to know anything concerning the Bibles, you scan here. But otherwise, God bless you so much. Our church is just opposite the police station. And anytime you want to visit us, you can always find us. Thank you so much, Flavia. Congratulations. God bless.